If you're in trouble, an emergency position indicating radio beacon, or EPIRB, may be your only means of getting help, so you need to know how to use it. An EPIRB is a buoyant radio transmitter that sends a continuous signal via satellite so that a rescue centre can locate you. So you need one if you're more than 5 nautical miles from shore in Gulf St Vincent or Spencer Gulf, or more than 3 nautical miles from shore in other state waters, apart from Lakes Albert and Alexandrina. To ensure your EPIRB works correctly in Australia, you need to make sure that it emits a 406 MHz transmission signal. Rescue centres take all signals very seriously, and so they are only to be used after all other means of indicating distress have been used. For instance, using your marine radio or activating your flares. They are pretty robust devices, but they still need to be kept in a dry place where you can get to it in a hurry. In this boat, I'd put it in my grab bag. They also need to be tested every month in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions and registered with the Australian Maritime Safety Authority every 2 years, which is a free registration. Testing your EPIRB should only be done in the first 5 minutes of every hour. You would open the cover and briefly press the yellow button. You will hear a beep and the green light will flash. This shows the correct operation. To activate the EPIRB, you will take it from its cradle or from the grab bag. Make sure the antenna is upright. Open the cover and you would operate the switch. Close the cover. Unravel the line. And you would either attach this to your vessel, the life raft, or to your life jacket. Once you're sure that it's securely attached, throw it into the water. Don't hold onto it because it works best when it's floating. The battery on your EPIRB will need to be replaced if it's used or by the expiry date, which is indicated on the side of the unit. We're always happy to answer questions about boating safety, so if you see us around, come up and ask.